Very good morning to all my dear students. So we were doing the chapter of social inequalities. Now we have to start the other topic, that is provision by the government for SCs and STs, that is scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. There are provisions, and under provisions we have reservations and laws. अब laws हैं, policies हैं, amendments हैं और welfare programs हैं. ये सब चीज़ें they were meant for socially and economically backward classes. Right? Why? Because they were not having life chances, they were not having much opportunities that they should have. इसीलिए government ने कुछ seats SCs और STs के लिए reserve की and it was decided that no upper class can take those seats. They were only reserved for SCs and STs. Reservation policies को लेकर आज तक भी you know some people they are upset about all these reservations and they protest against all this. But that was the law, that was a rule made by ताकि SCs और STs को भी equal opportunities मिले. Right, whether they get equal opportunities in case of educational institutions, चाहे वो jobs है, parliament है. So they have now a lot of provisions like age relaxation and low marks for selection. तो उनके लिए भी कुछ opportunities derive करनी थी जिसकी वजह से ये सब laws बनाए गए, जैसे कि चाहे education institution की बात करें हम. So there was some relaxation in marks. ये नहीं है कि they have to score very high to get admissions. So it was a criteria that even on the low basis, low marks, they can get selected. And also there was some age relaxation if we talk about jobs. Now certain laws were made. Everyone have to implement all these laws. It was a legal framework and it was not like norms ke follow kiya to kiya. But these were laws which everyone have to follow. Brahmins, they were the only educated people and the British needed the Brahmin support. Now certain laws were made, लेकिन ये laws किस हद तक implement किए गए. First was Caste Disability Removal Act 1950. It was introduced because they wanted to get lower caste into the education institutions, ताकि उनको भी education मिल सके, they could also educate themselves. Then there was abolition of Untouchability Act, लेकिन आज भी untouchability बहुत rural areas में खासतौर से it is still practiced and it was punishable by law. Then Prevention of Atrocities Act, this act, इसमें ये था कि Brahmins they carried out on lower caste, मतलब उनको मारना, उनको अच्छे कलर्स के कपड़े नहीं पहनने देना, उनको typical washing streets like jobs में involve करना, washing washrooms and all that. So that was abolished. And there was Constitution Amendment Act of 2005. It is to do with the education and no one can be devoid of education, चाहे वो किसी भी caste को belong करता हो, चाहे वो economically, socially backward classes हों, किसी भी चीज़ में हो, they all had to get education. So all were fighting for the rights and opportunities for social castes and social tribes. इसीलिए वो कुछ laws, ये कुछ laws बनाए गए थे. लेकिन अगर हम बात करें laws की कि कुछ हद तक these laws are still not implemented. Right, so they have to be implemented. And why, that's why these laws were made, ताकि अगर कोई इनको implement ना करे, they can be punishable under law. Right? So like beating Brahmins, they used to beat, तो ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए था. That's why these laws were enforced on all the people and they were mandatory for everyone. Their implementation was mandatory for everyone. So there was various movements like Satya Shodhak Samaj, or you can say the Truth Seekers Society. It was mainly for the Dalits and women by Jyotiba Phule. Then there was Brahma Samaj, Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Then there was Arya Samaj by Dayanand Saraswati. Dalit Sangharsh Samiti, Bahujan Samaj Party, BSP. Then Dalit Panther Movement in 1970s. So, ye sab cheeze, it was all for the welfare of SCs and STs. Jitni bhi movement start hui. And all the social reformers who were involved in all this, about these social reformers few we have already done before. Next is the other backward classes. After SCs and STs, there was OBCs. Those groups of forward caste who are economically backward. They are poor and they are treated like Dalits, but there is no untouchability. Untouchability was only in SCs and STs. Farak itna tha ki OBCs mein untouchability nahi thi, but they were also treated like them only, lower caste. Now reservations are provided to them since they are illiterate, uneducated and are given the same jobs as Dalits. So under this, there was Kaka Kalekar Commission. It was set up to go to different villages to decide the caste, subcaste should be given to the status of OBC. मतलब उनके बेनिफिट के लिए स्टार्ट हुई कि किस किस कास्ट सब कास्ट दैट शुड बी गिवन द स्टेटस ऑफ ओबीसी. दे हैड टू टेक अराउंड एंड दे हैड टू चेक ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. देन मंडल कमीशन वॉज देयर. देर वॉज अ लार्ज इश्यूज इन लेट 80s एंड 90s. वीपी सिंह ही गेव रिजर्वेशन इन सम स्टेट्स बट नॉट इन अदर स्टेट्स. तो रिजर्वेशन को लेकर कहीं प्रॉब्लम्स भी क्रिएट हुई हैं एंड दिस लेड टू द प्रोटेस्ट बाय अदर पीपल. एज आईव टोल्ड यू प्रीवियसली कि रिजर्वेशन पॉलिसी को लेकर काफ़ी लोगों ने ऑलरेडी प्रोटेस्ट भी किया. देन देयर वॉज पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ ओबीसी. Politicians promised reservation for OBC only to expand their vote bank. And those OBCs that are better off than the other OBCs are upper OBCs. The lowest category is equal to Dalits. मतलब OBC में भी categories थी upper and lower ones. ठीक है. और ये सब politicians जो थे उनको अपने फ़ायदे के लिए use करते थे for reservation of that. Then there was Adivasi struggle. In which they liked to be alone, isolated, the Adivasis. And occupations were well connected to the forest. जैसे मैंने आपको आदिवासी के बारे में दे वर द हंटर गैदरर्स मैंने आपको बताया भी था. एंड दे वर द हनी कलेक्टर्स. उनके जॉब जो थे दे वर मोस्टली ऑफ गैदरिंग हंटिंग एंड गैदरिंग एंड कलेक्टिंग हनी और यू कैन से द शिफ्टिंग कल्टिवेटर्स. तो उनको शुरू से ही लोअर कास्ट में ट्रीट किया गया था. दे वर ट्रीटेड एज फॉरेस्ट ड्वेलर्स. गिरिजन्स भी कहते हैं इनको. सो दे वर डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज अंडर ओबीसी एज वेल. जिन ओबीसी से लगता था फ़ायदा है उनको कुछ अपर कास्ट ओबीसी का स्टेटस दे दिया जाता था और बाकियों को एज लोअर कास्ट और दलित्स. सो देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ यू कैन से अ लॉट ऑफ प्रोटेस्ट वर आल्सो मेड अगेंस्ट ऑल दिस बट इट वाज स्टिल कंटिन्यूड. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू टिल हेयर. द असाइनमेंट रिलेटेड टू द सेम हैव बीन अपलोडेड ऑन द वेबसाइट. प्लीज़ डू दैट एंड टेक केयर ऑफ़ योर सेल्फ. थैंक यू.